I will try to share with you, along with myself, with the hope that I'll take my lesson and try to make the best of it. As today is the 3rd of Sha'ban, we are left with 26 or 27 more days left in this month. And along with those 26 or 27 days, we have the Shab Bara'. That's one of the holiest nights that we can reap the fruits of, inshallah. So the intention here is for me to understand, for myself, to understand how important this month is in my life and what I would gain out of it. I would like to start with depicting how a man's life carries on naturally, normally. We are all travelers. Travelers in the path that crosses through the mountains, the rivers, the seas, I'm referring to the obstacles of our lives, the deserts. And as we go along, we collect dust and the dirt and the rain. And along the line, we require cleansing and cleanliness. We go out into the market, and as we go out to the market, our heart becomes ignorant of the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our minds get busy with the trades and businesses and becomes ignorant of the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our intentions and our focuses get deviated from the most important purpose of our lives, which is, as the Quran says, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as they get in ghafla, in forgetfulness, then we collect dust along the line. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts up, I'd like to use the word or the simile of showers along our lives, that we go in there, cleanse ourselves, so that we would carry on our lives with clean soul, clean mind, clean intention, and clean hearts. Now the night of Jumu'ahs are one of them. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put up those nights for every week, so that we can clean up our dust during the evenings or the nights of Jumu'ah. The 8 days are another one. Laylatul Qadr is probably the biggest, not probably, as the Quran confirms, is the biggest one. And the Shab Bara' is another one. The first 10 days of the month of Muharram is another episode or the period of cleansing for all of us. Now the month of Sha'ban is one of those nights that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has reported to have said in the Kishf al-Khufa, is one of the hadiths, that the month of Sha'ban is my month, and it is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanses up the sins. So this is the confirmation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us an informing us of the opportunity of the month of Sha'ban, and he names it as his own month, and in it we will be cleansed of our sins, as in the confirmation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now the du'a that I have started my talk with, that Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna ila Ramadan, is a confirmation from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the month of Rajab and the month of Sha'ban are not any other months of the year besides the month of Ramadan, of course. So it is not like the other 11 months or other 9 months for that matter. They are different. So with that dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is declaring the sanctity of the month of Sha'ban, saying that it is the month Now, Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu one day asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is an allusion to what we should do in the month of Sha'ban. Said, O Rasulullah, in which period of time would be the fast the best of all the other times? Which month, which week should I fast? And that would be the best after the fast of the month of Ramadan. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now with that referred to the month of Sha'ban, saying that fasting in the month of Sha'ban would be the best of all the other fasts besides the month of Ramadan, the fast and the fast of Ramadan. But he added there another intention that actually is something I find very much important for myself. The point that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam highlights in this hadith, this one is reported in the Tirmizi, that this one would be the best if you are having the respect, the tahreem for the month of Ramadan. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was telling Sayyidina Anas, Hazrat Anas, that fast in this month, but do not forget that this fast is going to be a tahreem, a respect for the month of Ramadan. So if you have that, then this fast will be the best. So what it means for me and for all of us is that the month of Sha'ban is a preparation for the month of Ramadan. It is having its illusions of forgiveness, illusions of gathering the sawab, illusions of elevation in the ranks, the ranks of spiritual realm of Ramadan in itself. So that one was the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's allusion to it. So it is the preparation for the month of Ramadan. Now, for that, this preparation must take in three different levels. The first one is the physical, physiological. Alhamdulillah, Allah is going to bless us with the second time, that we have to get up earlier than usual. If you're getting up at 5, now we'll get up at 4. So that will require an adaptation for that. So we need to train for it. We will have days without drinks and food, and our blood sugar will require to be adjusted. Our body must get ready for it, that when the sugar level drops, we should still be able to function our day-to-day duties. And that drop in sugar level has different manifestations. For some people, it manifests itself in the form of short-temperedness. I don't know if anyone would understand that or relate to that. And having that is not actually a good reflection of fasting. It's a bad reflection on a person who is fasting. So if the person is fasting, the person's every component of the person, the mind, the body, the tongue, the language, everything should be fasting in the mellow and spiritual manner. And short-temperedness is not part of that. So one has to be trained for it. And at the same time, one's day-to-day functionality should not be dropped and diminished. Otherwise, if somebody is working for another person and is not performing well enough, then there is the right of the other person being infringed. And one should question whether the result of the income is halal or not. So and so forth. So that will require the physical adaptation to the month of Ramadan. And the Sha'ban, the fasting in the month of Sha'ban will provide us with that. The mental preparation is probably even more important and even more so in that way. You see, the month of Ramadan will be all the intentional alignment to the month. That it is the month that we have to reap the benefits from. It is the month that we have to get close. Now, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, this is the hadith that has been reported by Bukhari and Muslim. She is reporting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that he was fasting some months. He was fasting so much that we would think he never broke his fast, meaning he never missed a day. And there were some months that he would not fast, or he would fast so little that we thought he never fasted that long. But in the month of Sha'ban, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has fasted in the month of Sha'ban so much that he never fasted in any other month besides the Ramadan. Now there was another hadith of hadith that says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has never completed a month with full fast. But the month of Sha'ban was the one that he has fasted the most. But then again, in another hadith, this one is, they're all narrated in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, that Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has fasted the full month of Sha'ban. Now, in combination of the two hadith, ulama says, concludes that there were months or there were times that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has, from the beginning to the end, has completed the full month of Sha'ban with fast. And there were other years that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam missed days in it, but it was as if it was the full month. Now, this is what it is telling us, that it is the month for all of us that we have to reach our peak of fasting in any given month. So that's what the illusion and that's what the direction and guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for all of us. And the reason as it has been explained before, that we are getting ready for it physically, mentally, as well as emotionally, our heart. Our heart gets aligned with the month of Ramadan so that we would have the maximum benefit of it. Now, there is the other hadith. This one is narrated by